Are you curious? This is Angie Stewart from Mia Inner Light. And today we are going to talk about mediumship. And what is mediumship? Mediumship is this capability that special people called mediums have to connect with spirits. Spirits are the people that lived on earth and they die. They are discarnated. They are dead for the physical realm, but they are pretty much alive in the spiritual realm. It's important for you to know that we are all mediums, every single human being. Yes, even you, that you are saying, no, I never heard, I never saw anything. But yes, you are a medium too. The difference is there are ostensive mediums and the majority of the population that they cannot hear or see anything. But even those that cannot see spirits, cannot feel or even touch the spirits or being touched, they are mediums because we have a sensibility. Many times we call this extra sensibility just a coincidence. For example, it's very common from nowhere you start thinking about someone. Maybe someone you love, but maybe someone that you haven't even thought in a long, long time. And you think and you're like, that's so funny. Why am I thinking about this person? I haven't spoken to him or her through many, many years. And then few hours pass, maybe few days pass, and that person contacts you. And then you say, this is such a coincidence because I was just thinking about you a few days ago. And then you're gonna say, wow, coincidence? We know in Spiritism there are no coincidences. There is an old book that I read, that's not a Spiritist book, but was really good. It was called The Celestine Prophecy. And there, the author explained there is no coincidences, are concentrations of energy. And in Spiritism, we explain this also as a mediumship, because that person, from wherever the person is, start thinking of you, start sending these vibrations, these emanations, thinking of you, of your person, and you felt it, you captured it through your mediumship. So you have the sensation that the person was thinking of you, and boom, when the person contacted you, it happened. So this happens to every single human being. But the ostensive mediums are those people who actually can see, hear, they can feel spirits, or they can feel in the ambience. It's a spiritual connection. This spiritual connection can be good or not that good. But the difference is mediumship always existed. It's not something new, but it's something actually very, very old. It's actually described in Egyptian books. It's described through the time of Moses, to the time of Socrates. Socrates. Remember, in the time of Socrates, there was an oracle who said Socrates was the most intelligent man of his time. Socrates got a little annoyed and he actually decided to search who is more intelligent than him, because he does not think he was actually that intelligent or wise, as the oracle said. So who is this oracle? The oracle was a medium, was a man or a woman that actually had this capability of connecting with spirits and had special insights. So nowadays we have the Spiritist movement because of mediums. The last time we spoke about what is Spiritism, we learned about a man called Professor Rivail, who was actually nicknamed Allan Kardec. And Allan Kardec used many mediums in order to have answers to his questions. Because of these mediums, who actually, most of them were very young girls, they were able to give very, very intelligent answers to his questions. And then he was able to connect everything and codify the Spiritist doctrine for all of us. That's why nowadays we have all his codification, the Spirit's book with 1,019 questions and answers. But we have many other books, and what I mentioned yesterday, the second book is this one. The second book is the Medium's book. And this book here, look how thick. This book here have the answers to all your questions about the mediumship, the different types of mediumship, the different type of phenomena, and who exactly are mediums, and how they can understand what is mediumship. One thing we have to understand that in the past, mediumship was pretty much connected with schizophrenia. Yes, the disease of the mind. And because science could not understand mediumship or connection with spirits, anyone who said, "I see spirits," they were immediately cataloged as schizophrenic. So they were brought to a hospital, and in most of the cases, they were heavily medicated. And then, of course, there are many consequences to it. So we have to understand that nowadays, the Spiritism gave us this blessing of not immediately be brought to a hospital. Of course, there are situations and situations. Mediumship is a blessing, but if it's not controlled, it can be a problem. So yes, if you know anyone who has characteristics of mediumship, but is out of control, the person is not really be able to perform a normal life, yes, would be good if you could help this person to get medical help through a psychologist, a psychiatrist, but also through a spiritist center. Because in spiritist centers, we understand mediumship, and there are many different treatments to help this person. So the idea is to have both in balance, a physical doctor, but also the help of the spiritual doctors through a spiritist center. So in a spiritist center, this person can have the help of a healing passes, a spiritual treatment, the fluidified water, that's like a physical medication done by the spirits. And this all also including lectures, studies, reading and deeply studying this book, the person will be able to start understanding what's happening to him or her, what type of phenomena, and then find the balance, because mediumship is a blessing, but you need to find the balance to don't become really crazy. And nowadays there are many important studies through doctors that talk about the pineal gland. I think you probably already heard. Pineal gland is the gland that actually connects the human beings with the spiritual realm. There are many studies about it. There are many Brazilian doctors that studied deeply. I can tell you the name of George Andrea and also Dr. Sergio Felipe Oliveira. They are doctors that dedicated their lives to this deep study. So this can help you to understand it a little bit better. Another book that is super interesting is this book. You see, this is The Spirit's Review, written by Allan Kardec in 1858. And in this book, Kardec wrote every single mediumistic meeting he had. All the spirits he was able to talk, and many of them he called, so they answered questions for him, and he wrote in these magazines. There are many. This is the first one. So there you can understand how it happened in that time. But nowadays it's different. Nowadays we follow what Chico Xavier explained. Mediumship is not from here, there, but it's from there, here. Meaning the telephone calls from there, here. So the spirits contact us. It's not that we contacted them. So I hope this was interesting for you. Are you curious? See you soon.